Hello everyone, this is Sheila Ratna Bansode from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to see the topic section of solids, and in that particularly we will be dealing with the solid type prism. Let us move further. The learning outcomes. At the end of this session, students will be able to draw the sectional view of prism. As we all know, prism is a kind of solid which has a base and a top parallel to each other. We can have a square prism, a hexagonal prism, a pentagonal prism, or a triangular prism. So we can say that the prism has faces as well as edges. Now let us move further. An example, a hexagonal prism 35 mm side and axis 70 mm long is resting on one of its base edges on the ground, that is HP, such that the axis is inclined at 30 degrees to HP and parallel to VP. It is cut by an inclined plane at an angle of 45 degrees to HP and perpendicular to VP, and the same cutting plane passes at a distance of 25 mm above the base along the axis. And for this case we have to draw the front view and the sectional top view. Now analyzing the question, we can say that, or from this condition, that the prism is resting on one of its base edges on the ground. From this condition, we can say that the prism is resting on its base on HP, that is horizontal plane or the ground, in the first stage. As this problem being of two stages, in the second stage, we'll obtain the desired sectional front view and the desired sectional top view and front view. So in the first case, we need to draw the hexagonal prism resting on HP. Further, it is cut by inclined plane, which is inclined at 45 degrees to HP. Inclination with HP is seen in front view, and the cutting plane is also perpendicular to VP. Hence, the cutting plane will be seen as a line view in front view. One more condition for the prism is that the prism has its base edge in contact with HP, such that the axis of the prism makes an angle of 30 degrees to HP. So this shows the second condition of the prism, or the final condition of the prism, where we need to cut the prism by this given plane, which is 45 degrees inclined to HP. Let us move further to draw the given prism. First, the XY line or the reference line. Now, as the prism is resting on HP, we'll start with top view, where we'll draw a hexagon. The position of the hexagon is the two edges are perpendicular to XY. This hexagon of 35 mm side, we'll name it. Before that, we'll project this all the corners in vertically upward direction, so that we can complete the hexagon in front view. As you can see, at the middle you get an edge, so we have darkened this line. This is height 70 mm. This is the naming. So we have named it as 1, 2, 3, 4 in this fashion, and corresponding naming in the front view as 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 6 dash, and 4 dash, 5 dash. Now this is the first or the initial condition. Now moving further for second condition. The second condition is This prism will be inclined at an angle of 30 degrees to HP. So we have to redraw the front view with an inclination of 30 degrees to HP, but the condition is that the edge 4, 5, the edge 4, 5 will be in contact with XY. So let us draw this, or let us redraw the front view at an given inclination. So you can see that the edge 4, 5 is in contact with XY and the axis is inclined at 30 degrees to HP. We'll complete the naming. So this is the required position of the prism as per the given condition. Now, moving towards the cutting plane. So this is the cutting plane. As the cutting plane is perpendicular to VP, it is seen as an line view, plus it is inclined at an angle of 45 degrees to HP and 25 mm from base. 25 mm distance will be measured on this edge 3-6-. Now let us complete the top view. Project the points. Before that, we have darkened the remaining part of the cone, remaining part of the prism. Now projecting the points, point 1-2 will be projected from top view, front view, and corresponding point 1 and 2 will be projected from the previous top view. Similarly, projecting the points 3-6 and 4-5, we get the required base of the prism, which is named as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is the required base. We'll join this. So this is the part which stays after cutting the prism. Moving further, now here on screen you can see that we have obtained the points P1, P2, P3, P4 and so on. These are the points from this cutting plane. So wherever the cutting plane shown in red cuts the edges, we have named those points as P. So cutting plane cutting the edge 1-2 will be named as P1, P2. Here P3, P4 or P3, P6 and here 4 and 5. Now point P1, P2 will be projected on the side 1 and side 2. So we will get the point P1 and P2. Similarly, point P3, P4, P5 and P6 will be obtained by projecting those points on the corresponding sides in the top view. So this is the required sectional view of the section that is being obtained after by cutting the prism in the required fashion. We'll dark the remaining portion of the prism. So this part of the prism stays after being cut. The inner sides will be in dotted form as they are hidden, and we'll draw the section lines at the cutting part. So this is the complete projection of the prism, that is hexagonal prism, when it is cut by an angle of 45 degrees the cutting plane makes, and when the prism makes an angle of 30 degrees with HP. Thank you.